Hello friends, welcome to Vidya's Cooking. This is Vidya Lakshmi. I'm back with a new recipe. Today I'm going to show you how I prepared fish chilli. Fish chilli is an Indo-Chinese recipe. It pairs well with noodles and fried rice. And it also pairs very well with South Indian meals. I purchased this Mahi Mahi fish cubes from Fresh to Home. It's very neatly packaged and very convenient to use. This has got no bones in it and it's got no skin in it. Fresh to Home is a meat-based app company. They sell chemical-free and pesticide-free meats, fish, poultry. I've purchased a variety of meats from them. And this is the Mahi Mahi fish that I've purchased. And I stored it in the freezer. It stored very well. I'll be showing you all the ingredients that I used for this recipe. All the ingredients are prepped and reserved. So you've already seen how I washed and cleaned the fish. It's completely washed, drained, and reserved in a bowl. This is 250 grams of fish. I'm going to be using ginger garlic paste, soya sauce, and spicy green chili sauce. Finely chopped garlic, ginger, red chilies, green chilies, curry leaves, half an onion which is cubed, and half a bell pepper which is cubed. Curry leaves, using curry leaves is optional. I'm going to use white of an egg, rice flour, turmeric powder, chili powder, and pepper powder. All the ingredients used in this recipe will be listed in the description box below this video. I've used a little extra items which I'll be showing you later in this video, which I've not placed it in this video clip. As I'm preparing the dish, I've used few extra ingredients. I'll be listing all of that also in the description box below this video. So I was tasting and preparing this dish. So while I was tasting and preparing, I felt I should add few more ingredients, and that's how I've added few more ingredients. Now I'm marinating the fish with a teaspoon of ginger and garlic paste, chili powder, turmeric powder, pepper powder, and I've also added rice flour. Now I'm going to add only the white or the egg white for the fish. I'm going to add very less amount of salt. Don't add excess salt because the sauces already contain a lot of salt. I'll marinate the fish, mix and marinate the fish. You can allow this to marinate for 10 to 15 minutes. Start frying the fish, deep frying the fish. I've heated oil on medium flame in a wok. I'm gently going to drop the fish in the hot oil and I'm going to fry it. So this will roughly take about 2 minutes time to fry on each side. The fish is very nice and juicy, very tender, so it hardly takes any time to cook. Only the masala has to cook and the outer covering has to turn crispy. So I'll just keep turning this for every 2 minutes, and once the outer covering is nice and crispy, you can drain it from oil and you can reserve it on a tissue paper. But you have to be very careful and gentle while you're turning this fish. It might tend to break and it can disintegrate in the oil. So you have to be very gentle while you're frying it. Don't turn it very harshly if you're preparing this recipe. You should be very gentle when you're using boneless fish. So I kept frying it for approximately 5 minutes. It took me roughly about 2 minutes to fry on each side. Once the outer covering has turned light golden brown in color, I've drained it from excess oil and I reserved it on a tissue paper, just for that excess oil to drain out. Many people also use colander to drain the excess oil. So the fish is done. Now I'm going to start preparing the base. I've heated a wok. I've added some ghee. A tablespoon and a half of ghee. Ghee gives good flavor. So this is Indo-Chinese recipe. Here in India you can find dishes, Indo-Chinese dishes prepared with ghee. I've started to fry the finely chopped ginger and garlic, dried red chilies, curry leaves, finely chopped chilies. I'm going to fry all the ingredients one at a time and make sure the aroma builds eventually in the dish. So these red chilies have a very nice kick or a punch when you add it to Chinese recipes. It gives a good aroma. I've also added ginger and garlic paste. I'll fry all the ingredients. The raw flavor should reduce. So whenever the raw flavor reduces, you'll have a good aroma in the dish. Now I've added the bell pepper and onions. Added 1/4 cup of water, and I'm also going to add little bit of salt and allow the veggies to cook, the bell pepper and onions. So all the veggies should cook and it should soften. Allow this to reduce on medium flame. At this point, I've added Szechuan masala, chili powder, because I was tasting the dish and I wanted to see how spicy it's going to be. We like it extra spicy, so that's the reason I've added extra ingredients. I'm going to add soya sauce. I'll be adding some chili sauce. Now again, I was tasting it, and depending on the taste, I've added the other ingredient as well. I'm going to add a chunky sweet chili sauce to this recipe. That's optional. If you want to add it, you can add it or leave it out. You find this nice and chunky sweet chili sauce across supermarkets. So this is what I'm adding at this point. You can also use tomato ketchup. I've added the chunky sweet chili sauce. This is very tasty. Now I'm going to fry all the ingredients. At this point, the masala base is ready. I'm going to transfer the fish. So somebody also pointed out, don't place your ingredients which you've fried on the tissue paper, because the tissue paper will stick to the product. I do agree. So you have to check your fish once any product you fry and serve. Any product you fry and place it on the tissue paper, it might tend to stick to the product. So make sure there is no tissue paper and just add only the fried product to the masala which you're preparing. So that's what I've done. I've checked the fish and I've added it to the masala. And I gave it a good toss. I've also added some lemon juice and little bit of vinegar. Check for salt and add salt if needed. All the ingredients used in this recipe will be listed in the description box below this video. Or you can click the icon above this video, which will direct you to my blog. For regular updates, do like me and follow me on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. All my social media handle links will also be in the description box below this video. The same recipes are also translated and posted in YouTube Tamil. YouTube Tamil link will also be in the description box below this video. I've just garnished it with coriander and green onions and I've served it. This should be eaten as hot as possible. It tasted excellent. The fish was nice and juicy. It was almost creamy. It was very nice and tasty. Give this recipe a try and post your comments. If you enjoyed watching this video recipe, give me a thumbs up and subscribe to me for more recipes. I'll be seeing you soon with the next recipe video. This is Vidya Lakshmi. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.